Rolling.
Thermodynamics. Cells follow the rules of the universe. That's the bottom line. I'd like you to understand some of the rules of the universe. You've seen this since you've had freshman chemistry. You've seen these thermodynamics equations before. So don't be afraid. Here they come. And it turns out cells use these. Enzymes use thermodynamics to catalyze reaction. Cells use energy and manipulate energy. Cells follow the rules of the universe. Cells are part of the universe. All this stuff about the Force, Star Wars, that's in Star Wars. Cells follow the rules of the universe. I want you to remember that. They follow the rules of thermodynamics. So what is thermodynamics? It's got nothing to do with temperature fluctuations. They're not formulas used in physics and chemistry only. And it's got nothing to do with volcanoes. The correct answer here, thermodynamics are rules that govern the transformations in the universe. Okay? So, there are three laws. Count them. Three. First law, energy is conserved. Okay? It just doesn't come out of nowhere. Okay? So that means in any kind of reaction, the energy coming out has to equal the energy coming in. The energy in minus the energy stored is another way of putting that. So we can write that in as an equation. E is for energy. These little delta things, that's a Greek D, that means the change in energy is the energy of the products minus the energy of the reactants. So if the products have stored energy, the energy is released and you can form reactants. Stored energy can be called enthalpy. And that's sometimes referred to as heat content, enthalpy. And that's H. So H stands for heat, but it's really stored energy in chemical bonds. Okay? Bonds that have a lot of energy. So that is the energy plus the pressure times the volume. Okay? In life, pressure and volume don't change much. In other words, the change, the delta PV, is zero. Because, you know, we're all kind of swimming around here, you know, the same atmospheric pressure. And we don't substantially change volume. Well, some people do, but it takes a long time. So in cells, the change in enthalpy is roughly equivalent to the change in energy. Okay? And in all chemical reactions, the change is conserved. So the change in enthalpy is the change is the products minus the reactants. Okay? No, we're just substituting H here for E because cells don't change their pressure and their volume. And a reaction can be called exothermic if the change is negative. Exothermic releases energy. And endothermic if it takes energy. So if you've ever dissolved things in water, if you put acid in water, it gets really hot. Okay? Exothermic. If you put base in water, it gets really cold. Endothermic. It takes energy. Okay. What is the second law of thermodynamics? Disorder. Spontaneous reactions increase disorder. The universe is getting more and more disordered every day. Disorder. Entropy is disorder. S. Disorder. So now we can talk about free energy. Okay? Here's our old friend enthalpy. Here's our new friend entropy. And T is for temperature. Okay? So free energy is called the Gibbs free energy, or G. And that is the enthalpy minus TS, temperature entropy. We put the delta in, and at constant temperature, that means T is not changing, delta G, the change in Gibbs free energy, is delta H, change in enthalpy, minus T times the change in entropy. We'll see this over and over again. If delta G is negative, the reaction is spontaneous. Okay, this deserves the green pointer.
Delta G is negative.
The reaction is spontaneous. It will occur. Okay, that's an important point. I'm going to jump up and down. I'm going to point the green pointer and the red pointer at the same time. Delta G is negative. The reaction will occur. We're going to come back to this. So the third law of thermodynamics, some of you chemists will remember this, but for biologists, it doesn't matter so much. The entropy of anything is zero at absolute zero. Absolute zero is minus 273 degrees Celsius or 0 degrees Kelvin. That means nothing's moving, okay? Dead frozen, even helium is frozen, okay? Not much happens in living systems at this temperature. So we can go on and talk about how thermodynamics help us to understand reactions in cells. So we have to understand two things, equilibrium and rate, okay? What is equilibrium? Equilibrium is when the reaction is at steady state, okay? There's an equilibrium constant, and the free energy change is neutral at equilibrium. Rate is how fast things go if the reaction is spontaneous, if delta G is negative. So at equilibrium, the rate of the forward and reverse reaction are equal, and there's no change in the products or reactants, okay? It could be that it's constantly happening, but there's no change in the concentrations of each of those things. The equilibrium constant defines the ratio of products to reactants, okay? And it's not affected by the rate. So in this reaction, A plus B goes to C plus D. The equilibrium constant is products over reactants. The free energy change determines the direction of the reaction. Reactions proceed when the delta G is negative. The products will form when the delta G is negative. If the delta G is positive, the reaction will tend towards reactants. Okay? Reactions are at equilibrium when delta G is zero. Let me say that again. Reactions are at equilibrium when the free energy change is zero. And remember, free energy is enthalpy minus T delta entropy. Okay, so biochemists use standard free energy. As defined as something that happens at a reasonable temperature, 25 degrees, that's room temperature, centigrade, at a reasonable pressure, 1 atmosphere, that's life on Earth. And to make the math simple, components are at 1 molar, and for biochemists, the concentration of water is 55 molar, and the pH is 7, or neutral. Okay. So that's called the standard free energy, and that's delta G naught. You'll see that more when you take biochemistry. delta G naught is the gas constant times the temperature times the logarithm of products over reactants. And that happens to be the equilibrium constant. So delta G naught equals RT ln KEQ. So that's the equilibrium constant, gas constant, temperature. So the free energy of the reaction is this standard thing plus whatever the formation of products and reactants will produce to change the delta G to be positive or negative. So we can just call these two things, RT, a constant. And we can learn that we can define whether a reaction will go forward or backwards by knowing the standard free energy and knowing the concentration of products and reactants. We'll see this later when we see that the concentration of ATP is high in cells, and that makes reactions to hydrolyze ATP, to use that energy, go forward even faster. So delta G naught is standard conditions delta G, room temperature, one atmosphere, neutral pH, and we can define it as this equation using the equilibrium constant. So that's equilibrium. Now, rate. Rate is how fast things go. Rate doesn't have anything to do with the direction of the reaction.
So delta G is negative, the reaction will go forward.
So if delta G is negative, the reaction will go forward. The rate is different. If delta G is negative, the rate will say how fast it will go forward. Okay, so the rate and the direction are not the same thing. Okay, it's time for the green pointer. The rate and the direction are not the same thing. The direction of the reaction is dictated by the delta G, and the rate is indicated by the activation energy, okay? Here we get the humps. We'll get the hump diagram in a second. To get over the activation energy, you need a catalyst. And biological reactions are catalyzed by enzymes. Enzymes are biological catalysts. They enhance the rate, but not the direction. They don't determine the direction, okay? This is very easily confused, and so I'm going to say it again. Enzymes are catalysts which affect the rate, but not the direction. That's indicated by the delta G, the free energy. So if you have a delta G diagram here, free energy on the y-axis and the progress of the reaction on the x-axis, you might have an activation energy to overcome in order for the reaction to go forward. So if the reactants have a higher free energy and the products have a lower, then the reaction will go forward. But it will go forward at a slow rate if the activation is high, if the activation energy is high. What enzymes do is they can make a transition state intermediate more accessible by twisting the shape of a molecule, for example. They lower the activation energy, make the reaction go faster. Okay? So they can stabilize a transition state and make the reaction go faster. So catalysts, like enzymes, increase the reaction rate by lowering the activation energy. But they don't change the direction of the reaction. So if the products were up here, the enzyme and the reactants were here, if the products are higher in delta G, the delta G would be positive. The enzyme won't help you because the reaction won't go forward. Enzymes affect the rate by lowering the activation energy. Enzymes bind substrates by multiple weak interactions and decrease the activation energy by stabilizing the transition state. So they twist the molecules so they're more easily going to that new state where they react with each other to form reactions, to form... They stabilize the entire... What enzymes do is they can make a transition state intermediate more accessible by twisting the shape of a molecule, for example.